We want to evaluate the given definite integral. To do this, we'll first find the antiderivative function using our integration formulas here. Then, once we find the antiderivative function, we'll use the fundamental theorem of calculus stated here to find the value of the definite integral. If big f of x is the antiderivative function, notice how the definite integral is equal to big f of b, where b is the upper limit of integration, minus big f of a, where a is the lower limit of integration. So let's begin by writing this as the integral from 1 to 4 of 2x to the first plus 1. So the antiderivative of 2x to the first would be 2 times x to the second. We add 1 to the exponent, and then divide by the new exponent, plus the antiderivative of 1, which would be 1 times x, or just x. Now we need to evaluate this at the upper and lower limits of integration, or 4 and 1. But before we do this, let's simplify a little bit. Notice here we have a 2 over 2. That would simplify to 1. So now we just have x squared plus x. And we'll first evaluate this at 4, then evaluate it at 1, and then find the difference. It's going to be equal to some quantity minus another quantity. So notice when x is 4, we would have 4 squared plus 4. When x is 1, we would have 1 squared plus 1. So here we'll have 16 plus 4, that's 20, minus, this would be 2. So the definite integral is equal to 18. Now I wanted to show the graph of this function as well, because notice how on the interval from 1 to 4, the function is non-negative, and therefore the definite integral would be equal to the area under the function and above the x-axis on this closed interval. Meaning if we found the area of this trapezoid, it would be equal to 18, the same value as the definite integral. I hope you found this explanation helpful.